Another month goes by, and it's time again to answer questions for the monthly AMA. If you'd like to ask a question for the month of September, just use the Patreon link in the description and become a patron at the $5 level. Now let's answer questions asked by patrons during the month of August. Jason Maltz asks, what is your opinion of the economies of Scandinavia or Germany? People always bring them up as examples of democratic socialism that works, and what we should model the U.S. after. Not Venezuela. Except they aren't. Politicians in these countries have said over and over again that they're not democratic socialists. They're social democracies with market economies. They may have particular policies, such as welfare or healthcare, where the government is doing more than in America, but those isolated policies are not the whole of the economy. In fact, Denmark, Sweden, and the Netherlands all rank above the U.S. on the Index of Economic Freedom, and Norway and Germany aren't that far behind. The score for the U.S. is 75.7 compared to 74.3 for Norway and 74.2 for Germany. And they're very business-friendly. Denmark, Norway, and Sweden are all in the top 10 on the World Bank's Ease of Doing Business rank. Business taxes are lower. There's a lot less regulation, and it's easy to register property and get permits. They also have no minimum wage. The only categories that America ranks better on, in fact, are protecting minority investors and resolving insolvency. In every other category, we struggle to stay in the top 50. Sweden also has school choice, including voucher programs for private schools, an idea that always makes socialists screech in horror. And they're also pulling back on these social programs, which are really only a few decades old, and they've been able to get by that far because of large oil reserves. But they're realizing that even that small amount of socialism just isn't sustainable. And Josh Havens asks, if we convert to an anarcho-capitalist society, the rich will buy the courts and police, the statist says. Then they can get away with anything. What is your response to this? Oh, those wacky statists. They say all sorts of crap, don't they? They always say out of the mouths of babes, but I think when you're comparing it to babes, this is more like what comes out of the other end. So, rich and powerful people with connections might be able to get away with criminal activity while whistleblowers get exiled and marginalized groups become victims of more and more police violence with no accountability whatsoever? Yeah, wouldn't it be horrible if that started happening? Sorry, I let Lord Killian out for a second there. But yeah, this is one more case of statists fear-mongering about something that will happen with anarcho-capitalism that already happens with the state. In reality, in an ANCAP society, they wouldn't be able to do this because they would have competition. If you keep coming into our black neighborhood and killing people, then we're not going to let you in anymore and we'll go with a competing police force. Or there are people spying on us and someone blows the whistle. They won't be able to do anything to the whistleblower because the police service he employs won't let them, and we'll be able to use our police against the spies. You ever notice how the statists bleed on about how Snowden is a traitor and needs to be brought to justice because he didn't go through the proper channels when he exposed these crimes? But they've done absolutely nothing whatsoever against the criminals he exposed. That could never be the case in an ANCAP society. And see, here's the thing, this is true with all sorts of subjects. We can go step by step as to why this wouldn't be a problem, but all the statists can do is just assert. They'll be able to buy up all the courts and police just because they can. Just reasons. So even if you don't accept my explanation, what possible justification is there for considering the baseless fear-mongering of the statists to be any better? So that's all the questions for August. Thanks as usual to everyone who asked questions and everyone else who has supported this channel. And thank you for watching. If you like this, please hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it. Until next time, stay strong and be free.